Hello, what's up, YouTube? I'm your best friend Pari Jain with a new bang on video of maths. Yes, guys, I think that you have read the title. So, but again, I would like to tell you that today we are going to do mathematics. Yes, guys, a very interesting subject, mathematics. So I have already done one part of mathematics in which we have done addition, subtraction and multiplication. Okay, so if you have not seen the video, then go to my channel and subscribe to it and just go for the link for the part one of mathematics. Okay, so guys, what are we going to do today? Okay, so we are going to do fractions. So guys, let's understand what is fractions. A fraction is a number that describes a relationship between a part represented by the numerator, okay, and a whole number represented by the denominator. Okay, so first of all, let me tell you what is numerator and what is denominator. If I will tell you this, then you will understand what is fractions. So let's know what is numerator. Number of parts we have. Numerator means a total number of parts which we have. Okay, and denominator is equals to total parts in a whole number. A total part in a whole number means total parts left it in the the total part which we have in the shape, and numerator is equals to number of parts we are having right now. There are left it. Okay, so you can see a shape below. You can see a block in which we have five lines we have in the block, and three are shaded, means in the three lines we have kept something or anything else. Okay, or we can say that three lines are left it and two are used. Okay, so this box is equals to a denominator. This box is not a denominator, but the lines given below are five. So five is denominator and three is numerator. You can see the example, right? And fraction bar is equals to that dash. You can see the arrow going on. Okay, so let's go to the next slide. And guys, this is very easy to understand with these examples. Okay, so your first example, you can see a circle is given which one part is shaded and second is non-shaded, and we have total two parts. So two is our denominator and one is shaded part. So one is a part which is left it in a pizza or anything else. Okay, so you can see the next example. Okay, so you can see here we have three equal parts and one is shaded. Three parts we have in a circle and one is shaded. So one is our numerator and three is our denominator. We never count the number or the block which is non-shaded or means not coming in the way we need. Okay, so you can see other examples. I will give you 5 seconds to learn these whole examples, because after this you will have to face some other examples also. So let me start the timer. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So guys, let's go to the next example. Next part. Okay, so types of fraction. Yeah, this is very important, guys. Be careful by reading this. What is types of fractions? What are the types of fractions? Fractions. In fractions, there are many types in which we have three types. Okay, the main three types I have taken here. Otherwise, there are two, three more. But right now in this video, we will be doing only these three. Okay, so first is proper fraction, second is improper fraction, and the third is mixed fraction. So let's learn what is proper fraction. Numerator is smaller than the denominator. A very simple definition of proper fraction. So numerator is smaller, okay, than the denominator. This equals to that you can see in the example given below. 1/2, very easy example. So 2 is obviously 2 is greater than 1. Right, so denominator is greater than numerator, means numerator is smaller than the denominator. You can see other examples also here. You can see 5/6, 3 by 4, 11 by 20, and 21 by 25. So 25 is the number, is the whole number, right? And 21 is the part left in or the part shaded. Okay, so 21 is obviously smaller than 25. So it means that this is a proper fraction is equals to numerator is smaller than the denominator. To know that what, how can we remember or how can we show you that numerator is smaller than the denominator. So you can obviously, I think that this is very easy after understanding addition, subtraction and multiplication. 21 is obviously smaller than 25. For understanding that, you can see 1 is smaller than 5. We know that. Okay. And 2 is equal to 2. So there is nothing big and small, but 1 is smaller than 5, right? So 21 is smaller than 25. Very easy, right? You can see a circle given below in the down. You can see one circle is there and there are 6 blocks. I mean, 6 parts we have and 5 are shaded. 1 is not shaded. Means this is like a pizza. We have 6 slices and 1 is eaten by your friend or you have only eaten the one slice and other 5 are shaded. Means the other 5 we have with their toppings, right? Okay. Now, what is improper fraction? We will go to the next is improper fraction. Obviously, when we learn other in Hindi and English, both we can see that if we want to know the opposite of a word, then we use im or un. Okay, im, un, this we use like undressed, undressed, dressed. So this is like opposite names. Okay, so proper fraction and improper fraction. So you can understand the what will be the difference is in proper fraction, numerator is smaller than the denominator. And in improper fraction, okay, just remember the word improper fraction. In improper fraction, we need numerator is equal or greater than the denominator. It is equal or greater than the denominator. All I am reading is in the slide, you can see, okay. And numerator is equal or greater than the denominator. Improper, we need numerator is smaller. And in improper, it should be equal or greater. It would be, okay. So you can see the examples given below. 3 by 2. 3 by 2 is equals to like 3 is greater than the 2. Obviously, we know 3 is greater than 2. Okay, and 7 is greater than 4. So it means numerator is greater than the denominator. And equal, you can see the 10 by 10. 10 by 10 is given. So 10 by 10 is equal to equal numbers. That is also improper because in proper fraction, we don't need equal. We don't need numerator greater, but we need numerator is smaller than the denominator. Okay. So just understand the opposite things. Then you will understand both the things, proper and improper fractions. So let's see the other examples also. 6 by 5, 15 by 11, 7 by 4. And 8 by 6 is given down. You can see with these both round circles. Okay. So you can see here, there is a block. There are two blocks, means two circles, which are of 6 equal parts. And in both of them, you can see we have to do equality. Okay. So you can say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 are there. Okay. You can count it out. And these 6 are shaded. In one circle, you can see that all 6 are shaded, and then the second one, 2 are shaded and other are left in. Okay, so 8 is the total number of these both circles. The parts are shaded. You can see 6 plus 2 is 7 and 8. So 8 is the number coming from adding this, and 6 is the number which is equal in both the circles. Both the circles are having same equal parts, so 6 is the number. Okay. So I think that it is clear what is proper fraction and what is improper. So let's go to the next. Mixed fraction. What is mixed fraction? This is some tricky thing, right? You will be thinking for a number, you can see, but no, it is not mixed with improper or proper. Okay. So let's learn what is mixed fraction. Consists of a whole number and a proper fraction. Yes. This needs only and only a whole number and a proper fraction. whole number is equals to which we need in all type of fractions. Okay, like whole number is equals to the denominator. If you want to know what is denominator, you can pause the video with the back slides. Okay, now what is a whole number? Whole number means, like we learn here, that a circle or a pizza is having six slices, and six slices are there, so six slices we have, that is a whole number we have. And then two I have eaten, or two my friend have eaten. So now how much are left it? Okay, so how much are left it, guys? Now let me know from you all, guys, what is left it? Yes, guys, four is left it, because six and five have been gone. So if you don't know how to do subtraction, then you can go with our another video. We have done subtraction, addition, and multiplication in that. Okay, so this is mixed fraction, is very easy. You can see the examples: 1 1 by 2, 2 3 by 4, and 5 5 by 6. Okay, and you can see the downer part. You can see six in a circle, six equal parts we have in a circle, and all six are shaded. In another one, you can see a one circle is there and two parts are shaded. These all is also 8, but we know what to do, right? So I will not explain it in the depth. Okay, so let's move to other examples and other things. Yes, guys, this is the last thing I'm gonna tell you with a cute example, actually. Okay, and here we have a watermelon, a one whole watermelon, you can see. Okay, and then when we divide the water, one watermelon, one whole watermelon equal in two equal parts, so each part is one half. This, when we divide a watermelon in two equal parts, then each part will get one and half part. Yes, guys, from one the half part is done, so both parts are one and half. Okay, so you can see in the below, you can see in the down part, you can see that one watermelon is now divided into four equal parts. So each part is 1/4. Each one part will get 1/4 part. Okay, because it is four times we have, means four equal parts we have done. So it will, a single partition will also get 1/4. So this is very easy. This is very easy example. I think that it is very easy. So bye and thanks for watching. For another videos, like, share, and subscribe to my channel. And on this video, I will aim 200k likes. Then we will make very exciting videos and challenges. Bye.